Welcome to Hobby Clubhouse with a review of the GSI Creos Mr. Hobby Gundam Marker EX Gundam Chrome Silver, which has been getting a lot of attention all over the internet for the impressive sheen that it can produce. And this is actually a reformulated version of a much older Gundam Chrome Silver that was discontinued nearly a decade ago. And here's a rare look at what the older version looks like thanks to this Twitter post from Japan. Also, make sure to stick around to the end where there will be a demo build using the markers. So with all that said, I'm sure you have a lot of questions about this product, so let's have a closer look. The new Gundam Chrome Silver was released in Japan on April 21, 2021, for a price of 660 yen each, so it's a lot steeper than a regular Gundam marker that's just 220 yen, or an EX one that's 330 yen. The outer package is special to this marker, with a shiny print up top that you'll never mistake this for other products. Not that you'll mistake it when you see the price at checkout. The back actually has something to tell us in English. So first of all, we're only supposed to use this on plastic models, and then don't use it on ABS plastic, and don't touch the surface or else you'll ruin the sheen, and the sheen will be affected if it dries in a humid environment. I think the touching thing may be the most inconvenient limitation, but we'll test it out in detail just how delicate the coat of paint really is. So for our test today, we're going to be looking at some common uses of the marker, and then after that, we're going to compare the chrome silver against some other silver colors. So first, let's see if the paint is prone to streaking or blotching, because it really is pointless if we can't get a good coat of paint altogether. So let's try coloring it by hand. And the results are very good. The plastic of the spoon I have is actually quite unfriendly to painting, and it's really hard for a coat to grip onto, but the paint still manages a nice thick surface. You don't see any unevenness for the most part, and you can see the beautiful coat laid down at the center. There is also no blotching, and the thick paint covers the base material very well. Again, the spoon is already a challenging surface for the paint, so this is really like the worst case scenario, and the paint will do really well on an actual model kit. Next, I wanted to see how it does with a paintbrush, but try as I may, the paint just wouldn't pour out of the marker. And I've noticed this on new markers where the paint just doesn't brush out of the tip, and where older ones would make a big old mess if you press right down on them. So I gave up after a little bit because I never got much paint out of the pen, so I ended up with a mess like this. So really, unfortunately, I'll have to try this another time and maybe make another update when I can get enough ink to use with a brush. But of course, we want to see it tested with the Gundam Marker airbrush system, and immediately you can see the beautiful, even coat laid down. So the simple word is, chrome silver works very well with the airbrush system. And yes, if you have sharp eyes, the one I have here is actually a third-party one, and it actually exists, but it works the same as the official one. If you're gonna paint a kit with chrome silver as the main color, you're definitely gonna want the airbrush system. But a bit more on that when we get to the demo build, there is a catch. So for applying the paint, the results are surprising. Using the chrome silver straight out of the pen works wonderfully, which you might not have expected. For paintbrush application, we're gonna have to reserve our judgment for now. And with the airbrush system, it works as well as we could possibly expect, and it gives us a wonderful, beautiful, even coat. So what about black surfaces? You see, metallic colors, especially chrome colors, often require a black undercoat for them to work properly. Now, we just saw that the chrome color here already works fine on white backing, but does the black surface make it even better? Well, the answer here is once again not what I expected. The black surface basically made no difference. It looks about the same as the white surface in every way, other than the black side looking a little bumpy and uneven because I didn't spray the black on so well. But that means the marker is really awesome in that it doesn't need you to do any extra work for it to look its best. It's got your back and it's ready to work. Okay, so how about that warning earlier not to touch the painted surface? Just how serious are they? Well, here's our spoon from earlier that was hand-painted, and it's had a few hours to dry now, and I'm pretty sure the surface has already set. Pressing my finger onto the surface, it immediately leaves a fingerprint. It's a little bit hard to see, but the surface has become cloudy. The paint doesn't come off or anything, but the sheen is definitely affected, so the package really isn't kidding about not touching it. Then you might get a little bit worried, so can we clean it if dust builds up on it? Well, fortunately yes, you can dust the surface with a brush and it doesn't seem to hurt the paint at all. And cleaning the surface with wet wipes seems okay too. It even cleared up a little bit of the part touched by a finger by just a little bit. It's again a little bit hard to see here, but it still doesn't completely fix up the surface. So the coat really is specifically weak to being directly touched, like the package says, so don't do it. Then just how strong is the coat itself? This has never been the Gundam Marker's forte, and it remains the same right here. The coat is quite easily scratched. Now it isn't flaky and it doesn't scratch off like a scratch off ticket, but it's quite soft and it's nonetheless gonna get damaged. So you're gonna want to consider if the surface you're gonna paint is gonna rub up against any other parts, and it's really nothing surprising here, really. So then obviously you're gonna think, well, let's give it a clear coat to protect it. Well, not so fast, my friend. Much like every other Gundam marker, the chrome silver does not like clear coats. So here I have a can of Mr. Hobby Super Clear Spray, and I only have the semi-gloss one here, but the thing I want to show you won't be affected by that little bit of detail. So here's what the chrome silver surface will look like if you apply a top coat spray onto it. The surface has become this strange uneven mess right here, with bits like this on the side here where the chrome silver was dissolved by the top coat and it has pooled together. And this bottom part here has the same thing. The middle section is bald and spotty after all that paint flowed away. Now if you're a builder, you know this means that you can't ever put a clear color over it, like clear yellow to turn it into gold. And that severely limits the flexibility for builds. This limitation is something really important to know if you plan to get this for builds, because it's not gonna work. But alongside this marker's release, we have another new product. This is the Mr. Hobby GM501 Clear Gloss, and it claims to play nicely with Gundam marker paints, so could this be our savior? Well, sad to say, not really. Now it's true that the clear gloss coat doesn't eat into the chrome silver paint, but at the same time, the gloss affects the sheen and it looks more like an aluminum surface now, which I suppose is something you now realize you can do if you want that. But otherwise, it does cloud up the sheen, so they don't really work together. Okay, so that's all the basic usage scenarios covered. Now let's do some comparisons. We'll be comparing the chrome silver with the following. The standard silver Gundam marker. The shine silver of the Gundam Marker EX series. The Tamiya X10 silver paint marker. And of course, a head-to-head with the legendary Molotow liquid chrome from Germany. So here it is next to the regular Gundam Marker Silver, and we kinda knew this wasn't gonna be a fair fight. The regular silver is long known to be a pretty dull color, and looks almost grayish on camera. Sure, it's just one third of the price, but I don't think anyone's gonna look at this and say the cost saving really was worthwhile. It is a clear win for the chrome silver. Next up, we have the EX Lines of Shine Silver, which we've seen in the EX Marker review. While the shine silver looks fantastic, it's not stunning like the chrome silver is, and there's just no shortcut or cheap trick to beat that beautiful mirrored surface. The EX Shine Silver is a really lovely color, but it is a silver color, and it's not chrome. That's another win for the chrome silver. Next, we have the Tamiya Silver Marker, which is a nice alternative to the regular silver Gundam marker, and sadly, it is really close to that regular silver, so it does look a little bit dull against the chrome silver. So this also won't be replacing the chrome silver in any build. That's 3 wins in the bag for the chrome silver so far. And last up, we have the comparison everyone came here to see, the Molotow Liquid Chrome. And side by side, if you weren't told, you might have a hard time telling the difference between the two, which is a massive praise for the Gundam marker, because the Molotow is beloved by many modelers and it's been an essential tool for chrome effects for many years. And now, the chrome silver Gundam marker is close enough to almost be an equal, so while this isn't a win, it's good enough to call it a draw. Now, of course, the Molotow has a slightly more reflective mirror sheen, so it's ever slightly better, and you'll probably find it more easily in stores, so it has that going for it. And that was the comparison, and it was pretty short because the difference is obvious. There is just no replacement for the marker if it's chrome silver that you need. It's just as good as the Molotow liquid chrome, and that's about the best praise it can possibly hope to get as a chrome marker. But of course, we're not done yet. For this review, we're gonna apply the silver marker to an actual build, the Silver Sumo from Turn A Gundam. While a Zoc is adorable and an entry-grade Gundam is very sensible as a choice, we need a kit that really fits the beautiful chrome surface, and that's what we have right here. And it's also real cheap. So the first step was to take care of some of the seams. The kit was reasonably easy to take apart, but it did have seams everywhere, so it was way more than I had time to fix up, so I had to draw the line somewhere and leave some bits of it untreated, like the shoulders. The first color to spray is the EX Lions' gunmetal, which we've seen in the EX Colored review. The frame and the joint parts all get this color, and it sprays on without any fuss at all. The second color is the star of the show, our chrome silver. And you can see as the color goes on, the pieces immediately get transformed by the sheen. You really can see the radical change right away because it's so good at covering the bottom color, it just does its job so flawlessly. And next we need to color the weapons here using Age Gray, which is really more like a dark blue. This will give us a bit of variety because the Sumo really has quite a simple color scheme. And here's the final result. In putting the plain kit here side by side, we can see just how much of a difference the chrome silver makes. The Sumo is also great for this demonstration because of all the curved surfaces that do a great job of showing off that silver texture. The silver chrome is smooth and it looks a lot like chrome, and almost as good as ones we get from the factory. And now for the bad news, and you might want to sit down for this. This build actually revealed to me that ultimately the chrome silver marker looks perfect, but it's a deal with the devil. As beautiful as this paint is, it's almost impossible to put this kit back together, and I'm serious. Just imagine having to put this kit back in one piece without touching any of the silver. Ultimately, I had to touch some of the silver parts, and you can see some of the silver was affected. This means that unlike other Gundam markers, you absolutely cannot use this as a base coat. It can only be used for smaller details or parts that you're sure you're gonna avoid touching. What's more, the chrome silver has the same limitation as every other Gundam marker, which is that you can only have one layer of color and absolutely nothing else on top. Now the clear gloss coat kind of works, but good luck painting any piece without touching it. So keep that logistical limitation in mind when you plan to use this marker for any build. With all that said, here's a Hobby Clubhouse 3-point verdict on the Mr. Hobby Gundam Marker EX Chrome Silver. Number 1. Its beautiful chrome was promised. The marker from a decade ago is a legend among Japanese builders for how stunning the chrome effect was. And a decade later, with a reformulated paint, the marker is back and it is as great as ever. There's good reason why Japanese fans are crazy about this, and this marker simply produces results that are as good as you ever hope. And number 2, it's shockingly convenient. Now builders will know that a beautiful silver coat needs a lot of work. The surface needs to be primed in black, the paint needs careful dilution, and the air pressure needs to be well controlled during spraying. And that's why it's hard to believe that something that comes out of a pen can look so nice. It's a valuable tool that's going to expand your options for detailing, and I've said this before, but a good tool should also be one that saves you time without coming at a huge cost, and the chrome silver marker really fits that bill. Or so I thought at first. Because number 3, it's a deal with the devil. Returning to that metaphor from just before, to get that beautiful chrome, you must accept some extreme trade-offs. You're not ever allowed to touch any surface you paint, and there's no trick around this, there is no remedy. All you can do is follow that rule and never ever touch the paint. And the silver here can't be top coated or painted over with other colors. So it's utterly unsuitable for a base coat on any build. It's a bit unfortunate, but once that all you feel when looking at the beautiful chrome silver finally settles, you're gonna realize that this thing is actually hellishly inflexible, and you're gonna have to work around it with some very careful planning. So that's a review of the Gundam Marker EX Chrome Silver. It's the prodigal son that you'll be quite eager to try out for yourself, limitations be damned. So keep your eye out and go hunt one down. It's not gonna be easy. Ultimately, I think it's a tool you're gonna like, even if it falls short of our wildest dreams. Thank you so much for watching. Come look us up on social media with updates on upcoming videos and sneak peeks at future projects, links are in the description below. Or hang on here to some of these other videos, like the review of the clear gloss and clear matte Gundam markers. But before you go, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to be notified of new videos from Hobby Clubhouse, and I'll see you next time.